It's Jones Society. On our first part, we failed. Hard,
he's charismatic.
Hello.
He's smart. He's Mr. Money in the Bank.
Come on. Come
he's
on.
The United States
come on.
Champion.
Well, Michael, he may not be one
oh,
of those
come on.
If he
let
lands
me
the Daniel
there
Bryan's
we go.
Lapel.
There we go. I won.
Bryan faced Miz in a submission match on Raw, and he made Miz tap faster than a heavy metal drummer. If that happens tonight, we'll have a new United
oh, damn,
States champion. Miz was saving himself.
Miz can wrestle.
You two brought up that acrimonious relationship between the Miz and Daniel Bryan. Miz abused
I feel
Bryan,
like...
and Bryan fought back, taking Miz's spot in the SummerSlam main event, and then his United States championship just a month later.
After laying dormant for a few years, the Miz and Daniel Bryan's hatred resurfaced in the infamous Talking Smack segment. After Daniel Bryan returned to action and pulled strings to get The Miz moved to SmackDown Live, this rivalry is
fought that was nice.
After 8 years. Now we have Daniel Bryan on the attack.
Between his championship, his briefcase, and his media obligations, Miz is slipping just a little here. He'll bounce back. Daniel Bryan may only be 8 months into his WWE career, but this is a decade-long journey for Bryan that could lead to his first taste of WWE gold here at Night of Champions.
It was March of 2000 when Daniel Bryan made his debut.
Oh, that was nice. I gotta say.
Michael's in. We might see Bryan make his first strides towards HBK level success if he can defeat The Miz tonight.
He breaks in.
He's not done just yet, Michael.
Nice drop toehold.
Put it like a bitch.
I don't know why anyone's surprised that The Miz and Daniel Bryan's relationship has come to this. The Miz can never keep an ally on his side.
Ain't that the truth? Every person the Awesome One has won the tag titles with has ended up hating The Miz. Remember the night after Extreme Rules when the Big Show's KO punch ended Show Miz?
He's flipped the switch, that's for sure.
Surprises him with that drop kick. Can he finish the job? The two of you brought up Miz's former partnerships, and can I just point out the common element between Bryan and the Miz's old tag partners? Just like Bryan, they were all jealous of the Miz. Drop down.
This is a level of destruction no one was expecting.
All right, now that way, that way.
Daniel Bryan always thought he was better than The Miz, but just look at what he's done since dumping Daniel Bryan. He's defending the United States Championship on pay-per-view, formed a tag team with Chris Jericho, and defeated seven men to win Money in the Bank.
Hey, that's impressive, but if Daniel Bryan was given those same kind of opportunities, he could be a tag team champion and a Money in the Bank winner.
Byron, you really ticked me off with that comment about The Miz being given opportunities like Money in the Bank.
Man.
He earned
oh,
those.
Damn.
And it's internet darlings like Daniel Bryan who everyone expects to get the red carpet treatment.
Oh, internet favorite or not, Daniel Bryan doesn't seem like the type to ask for chances. He's going to take them. And if not, then he'll demand them while trapping you in the lapel lock. This looks to be a barn burner, gentlemen. These two guys hate each other.
Corey, come on. The Miz is WWE's fastest rising star, and Daniel Bryan is a nerdy vegan. Bryan's got no chance here tonight.
Jesus, such slick movements with that
the
reversal.
Miz with the offense.
Michael may have ragged on Daniel Bryan's diet, but that quote-unquote nerdy vegan is WWE's most effective submission expert.
And Miz is as crafty as the day is long. That makes for a pretty interesting confrontation. Oh, man, right to the arm.
Hyper
extend your elbow.
The champion into the cover. I can't believe that Daniel Bryan even has a championship match here tonight. He basically quit NXT, becoming the first person eliminated. He is nothing more than a loser, like you, Saxton.
Well, I agree with the end there, Cole, but the elimination may have been a blessing in disguise. While the rest of the NXT performers formed a nexus, Daniel Bryan stood against their injustices in the main event of SummerSlam.
We discussed Daniel Bryan's last place finish on NXT back when he was on that show. Boy, am I glad he didn't win. Can you imagine this nerd in the main event WWE Championship match tonight, the NXT winner earned?
I can easily imagine it. Despite your thoughts, I believe that Daniel Bryan has many more.
Pinfall attempt here from Daniel Bryan.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
You sneaky bastard.
I just cannot believe the disrespect The Miz had to endure at the hands of Daniel Bryan. All he wanted to do on NXT was help Bryan, and that vegan nerd never listened.
Whoa, disrespect? Disrespect that The Miz slapped Daniel Bryan in the face on the very first episode of NXT. If I were ever to be on NXT, I'd never take that kind of abuse from my bro.
You on NXT?
You guys brought up Miz and Bryan's relationship on NXT. Obviously, Bryan can't learn any new moves from The Miz, but ironically, Bryan's hatred of The Miz did awaken the personality Miz said Bryan lacked.
Caught with the elbow.
Right on the jaw.
Tear his ass apart.
Here tonight against Daniel Bryan.
Well, it hasn't happened yet, has it, Byron?
It could be on the verge of occurring. Daniel Bryan from the top rope. Miz is in trouble.
Yeah, but look at the Miz fight back. What a warrior.
Great wherewithal from the Miz. Daniel Bryan hung out to dry. Just like that, the Miz has turned the tide in this matchup.
This is what I'm talking about.
The champion into the cover, digging deep for a kick out.
Way too early.
Oh, damn. New animation.
The champ to the top turnbuckle. The Miz showing how A-listers do things out there. He's flipped the switch, that's for sure.
Frustrations with Daniel Bryan have manifested in a methodical beating from Mr. Money in the Bank.
Well, if The Miz ends this soon, he might be healthy enough to cash in on the winner of the six-pack elimination WWE Championship match later on tonight. And if Bryan shows some agility. Nice job by Miz.
Great offense by The Miz. Look at this. He's inflicting some serious pain here.
Come on.
Oh, man. Right to the arm. Hyperextend your elbow. When this guy's on, look out.
Oh, my. The Miz. Daniel Bryan getting absolutely
fucking
right
The Miz
now.
Is kicking my ass.
Reality check is up.
Can he finish him off here?
Yeah, you don't see a slam like that very often.
Shoulders down. Championship on the line.
I don't know too many other guys that would have been able to kick out of that.
Only thing I can say is yes! Yes! Somehow Daniel Bryan is staying in it! That's and it's Bryan showing some agility.
Come on. Come on. Get on the floor.
A bell lock. The bell lock is in.
We might have a new champion here, guys.
Got it.
He did it. Daniel Bryan is U.S. champion.
No, no, it can't be.
I can watch highlights of that one all night long. One of the great WWE
back and forth
matches I've ever been able to watch. That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance.
Tonight, I just wish Daniel gave that level of commitment to his job as general manager of SmackDown Live.
And I'll tell you, the roof nearly blew off this place in Rosemont when the bell finally rang to end this one.
Look pretty damn nice to me.
We're in Boston in a building where many great champions have been crowned, and right now, the tag team titles are on the line. The champions, Kofi Kingston and R-Truth against the unlikely team of Daniel Bryan and Kane.
Talk about an odd couple, Michael. With everything we've seen from Bryan and Kane in the past few weeks, I gotta wonder if Dr. Shelby's anger management therapy can turn these two into a cohesive unit.
What do you know about therapists, Saxton? They've been thrusted into this position while the champions have been centered around their teamwork for the past 5 months. Kane and Bryan only have anger management in common. I wouldn't call that a building block towards tag team titles.
Clothesline!
Now we have Kane on the attack.
Statement as we speak.
teamwork at its best. He lands the strike with great accuracy.
We've been seeing Daniel and Kane in therapy for weeks now. It's not anger management that these two need. What they need is respect from the WWE Universe. These Yes Chance fans do are an absolute mockery to Daniel Bryan. I don't blame him one bit for being angry.
Right off the apron.
Oh, no.
You know, Corey, I see Daniel's issues with the S-Champ, but I don't have a problem with it. I mean, even in Montreal, where we were for Raw this past week, the crowd chants, we. So these Yes Chants are becoming bilingual.
Oh, very cute, Cole. Daniel Bryan's just a few feet away, and you're doing that. You should see if your friend Dr. Shelby does sensitivity training as well, because you need it.
Kane showing some expert prowess here. Dropped by the clothesline.
Ever since Kofi and R-Truth became allies, they've been on a tear in WWE. They know how to work together as a tag team. Then on the other side of the ring, judging from the last few weeks, Kane and Daniel Bryan are far from being on the same page.
Same page? Daniel and Kane aren't even reading the same book. Whereas Kofi and Truth, they're finishing each other's sentences.
And he tags his partner in.
Momentum has certainly shifted here, Michael.
We talk about being on the same page, and Truth and Kofi certainly are. But wouldn't you think Kane and Daniel Bryan's shared experience in anger management can create a chemistry of sorts?
Kofi and Truth have held those titles for 5 months. It'd be ridiculous to think that trust falls and yelling at kids wearing goat vests for a couple of weeks can get you the same kind of chemistry the tag team champions have.
Did Daniel Bryan's anger management issues begin way back in April at WrestleMania, when Bryan, who was World Heavyweight Champion at the time, lost his title to Sheamus in a record 18 seconds? It's been haunting Daniel Bryan for months.
Yes, it did. Listen, Daniel Bryan confessed that WrestleMania was the most embarrassing moment of his whole life, and that's including the time his fiance left him at the altar. Come to...
Kofi Kingston kicks out quickly. Gonna take more than that to take down Kingston. No telling how long he'll be able to keep this up.
Now we have Kane on the attack.
Look out, there he goes.
Knocked right off his feet. Of will Kane and Daniel Bryan be able to coexist? Looking like a moot point right now.
R-Truth needs to dig deep and find that there's something extra here, or this is going to be over. He doesn't want to do this outside the ring. Gets the tag. The human body only absorbs so much of that.
Leading up to this match, a lot of praise was thrown on Kofi and R-Truth. Kofi being a 3-time Intercontinental Champion and both having time as United States Champion. Well, Daniel Bryan has his accolades as well.
Of course, Daniel Bryan won the United States Championship at this same pay-per-view 2 years ago against The Miz. He also went on to win a Money in the Bank and become a World Heavyweight Champion.
Bringing up Daniel Bryan's time as World Heavyweight Champion, he did lose that title in only 18 seconds to Sheamus at WrestleMania.
Why? Why do you have to go and bring that up, Saxton? You know Daniel's in a fragile state right now, and you bring up a moment where he was caught off guard and hit by a now outlawed Bro King. Into the ring. Forget Daniel Bryan and Kane.
Here comes R-Truth. Oh, I think this man needs business.
I'm not sure how much he has left.
Look at this.
Oh.
Kofi dancing their way to win tonight.
These guys feel no love for each other. Here's another look.
I don't like to throw around a lot of praise, but my eyes tell me that might have been one of the great matches in recent WWE history. Hope everybody at home set those DVRs, because that was a match you're going to want to watch again and again and again.
WWE Tag Team Champion, Kofi Kingston and R-Truth.
Going to feel the effects of this win for a while.
I thought it was pretty good. I'm still going to keep it.
We're in Boston in a building where many great champions have been crowned, and right now, the tag team titles are on the line. The champions, Kofi Kingston and R-Truth, against the unlikely team of Daniel Bryan and Kane.
Talk about an odd couple, Michael. With everything we've seen from Bryan and Kane in the past few weeks, I gotta wonder if Dr. Shelby's anger management therapy can turn these two into a cohesive unit.
What do you know about therapists, Saxton? They've been thrusted into this position while the champions have been centered around their teamwork for the past 5 months. Kane and Bryan only have anger management in common. I wouldn't call that a building block towards tag team titles.
Kane with some good timing here. Some serious pain here. Down he goes with a scoop slam. Oh, I think this man means business. His strikes have a little extra on them tonight.
Oh, you cannot take your eyes off him for a second.
Really? Guys from the WWE Universe have the power on Monday Night Raw. They can be really nutty. Case in point, a few weeks ago, the WWE Universe voted on social media to have Daniel Bryan and Kane hug it out in the middle of the ring. Yes, folks, hug it out.
It was not a sight we usually see in a WWE ring. Kane and Daniel appeared to be two people that have never given a hug in their whole life. An awkward moment that showed they both still had a ways to go in their anger management.
The drop kick hits the target. So painful. You know, Byron, Kane and Daniel Bryan almost accidentally stumbled into this title opportunity when they defeated the Primetime Players on last week's Raw.
I can tell you it was no accident when Kane delivered a hateful choke slam on Bryan. It just so happened that Daniel landed on their opponent long enough to gain the pinfall. I can't foresee that being the outcome against the champions, though.
Right across the chest.
I think I hear R-Truth calling out for help from Little Jimmy.
Maybe his shoulders are down. Oh, quick kick out from R-Truth.
Nice kick out there.
One move after the other. It's devastating. Shelby deserves a Nobel Peace Prize.
Well, I hate to burst your bubble, Cole, but...
Uh-oh. And he makes it to the ropes.
Did you really doubt that he would? Come on, Cole.
R-Truth with a nice reversal. Boom. Right across the small of the back. Bringing it back into the ring. Inching closer to his partner. There it is. The tag has been made.
Oh, he needed that in the worst way, Michael.
Turning it around, it's Kofi Kingston. What a reversal. Goes down hard. Flashed him with a clothesline. Kofi Kingston with the offense. Daniel Bryan has so much on his mind right now. He was ballistic in a WWE.com interview. The problem is Daniel Bryan, he's a great competitor, but this crowd constantly distracts him. How can anybody do their work when this is going on?
Well, it's absolutely unfair. Bryan has to keep his anger in check while hearing the WWE Universe mock him. And then he also has to focus on his opponent. It's a lot to do.
Kingston in position. Is it? We touched on how much is going through. Clearly on a mission here. There it is. Kofi Kingston makes the cover.
Can he get him?
Ali, he's trying to mangle his face here.
Got him.
Shut it down. Here's the cover. And that's it. This one is over. We got our money's worth for that. Take a look. That was just one of those matches that the men involved should just be proud to be a part of. A legendary performance.
Here are your winners, and still WWE.
God damn it, Musty.